See, fear is actually a good thing. This is the difference between big-time people and small-time people. Big-time people, when they have fear, they take action. Small-time people, when they have fear, they contract. What activates the drive inside of a person? Okay, so when I wrote this book, I said there's five activators that activate this drive. There are more than five. Dan Pink wrote a great book called Drive. There's a lot of literature out there, but a lot of people don't focus on what actually activates the drive. So I'm going to give you my five. Number one, fear can activate the drive. If you look up the definition of fear in the dictionary, it says an unpleasant emotion, a belief. It's an unpleasant emotion that something could harm me in the future. What if fear could be good to activate a person's drive? What if I said fear is absolutely necessary to activate a person's prey drive? Could that activate my drive? Fear of losing? Yes or no? Yeah. See, fear is actually a good thing. This is the difference between big-time people and small-time people. Big-time people, when they have fear, they take action. Small-time people, when they have fear, they contract. It's real simple to me. So when in doubt, I take action. So fear is an emotion. It's a belief that something could harm me in the future. So a lot of times, fear, how you handle fear is important. Now, we know that under pressure, many times people do one of three things. They come out swinging, they fight, they flee, or let me tell you what we're seeing in this economy lately. They freeze. This is the third thing we're seeing people do. I can't tell you how many people I coach that spend most of their days whining, complaining about the economy, the rates, whatever the case may be. It's just hard. Here's what they do. They don't play offense. They play defense. So defense is sitting back. Now, when I was a basketball coach, how many basketball players are we having here, by the way? Some point. When I was a basketball coach, I wanted to get the ball to the midline in less than 2.3 seconds. I knew the percentages, and the percentages told me if I had gave up less than 14-second shots, or excuse me, had less than 14 turnovers, gave up less than 7-second shots, and I stopped the other team 21 times in a game, in increments of three consecutive stops, I won roughly 76 to 77% of the time. Everything I did was backward from knowing that. I wanted to get the ball to the midline in less than 2.3 seconds. Why? Because over a cycle of time of me just coming at you and coming at you and coming at you, it basically breaks your spirit because I just come at you so hard and so long that eventually you just say, I'm out. So I would teach my girl basketball players that when they put their hands on their knees, it's over. So about third quarter, free throw, they put their hands on their knees. My girl basketball players would look at me and say, it's over. See what I was building? Little Stone Cold killing machines. Activation, fear is an activator, prey drive. What about competition? Where's all my competitors in the room? People that want to win. People that want to be the best. Okay, competition is an activator, prey drive. What if I told you that I'm in competition with people who do not even know I'm in competition with them? Everybody see that? See, when I released this book, my agent said, man, it's a tough week to release the book. We're coming out against so-and-so and so-and-so and so-and-so. I said, good. Let the best man win. Let the best man win. Let's see who can win. This competition is an activator of prey drive. I believe every person in the room needs a trophy to win. They need a game to play. They need something to pursue.
You want to get a text daily from me, 5 days a week? Activate and reactivate the prey drive, some of my best concepts, a little shot of coach every single morning. I want you to text this number, text Monster Producer to this number, and I'd love to come into your life every single morning and get that prey drive activated. Let's go.
Now I'm going to tell you something about my grandfather because it ties into what you do. My grandfather got up and worked every single day on a farm in Tennessee. He became what's called a single-digit millionaire, which means his net worth was somewhere around $5 million. And he did it the old-fashioned way, built houses, sold land, bought things, farmed. Every day he got up and he went to work. He would come home at lunch and my grandmother would make him lunch. I would go to his house and he would give me little lessons. The lessons would be, son, it's out there. You just got to reach for it. If you can find a want to, if you got a want to, you can find a how to. I used to love going to see my grandfather. And then my grandfather decided to retire. My mom is a nurse. And my mom said to me, it's almost as if the day after your grandfather retired, everything in his life went downhill. His mind went downhill. His body went downhill. Everything went downhill. And you know what I'm convinced of? It's because he didn't have something to get up and fight for. He didn't have a game to play. He ran out of purpose. Joe Paterno, 82 years old, coaching Penn State, walking 25 miles a day, running gassers with his linemen. They fired him and he was dead in less than 6 months. Why? He ran out of purpose. Everybody see that? You got to start thinking bigger about how you're helping people. I come to you and I lost my hope, I lost my drive, I lost my focus, I lost my confidence. You know how hard that is for a man to say to somebody else? Because I coach men that will just break down and start crying right in the middle of my coaching session. I wake up with anxiety every morning. I lost all my drive. I've lost my confidence. I'm going through a divorce. I'm trying to get my mojo back. I can't tell you how many men come to me and say, look, man, I had it at one time, but I ain't got it anymore. I'm talking successful people. What can I do? I see me like you. They come, they go to the greatness factory. We reinvigorate them so they can go pursue their hopes and their dreams and their goals. So competition is an activator of prey drive. Number three, environment is an activator of prey drive. Could every little clinic be an incubator for greatness? Yes or no? Every little place, and I understand you guys are growing and you got different places around the country and you're growing. And here's the deal. How do I feel when I come in there? How do I feel about me when I'm with you? Do you give off the impression of increase? How do you make me feel when I walk in? Because when I started going to the doctor in Houston, I didn't feel like I was going to the doctor. I felt like I was going to the Ritz-Carlton. I had to remind myself I was at the doctor. I had to remind myself they're doing blood work on me. The providers were so professional. The nurses were so professional. The staff, Mr. Bird, it's so good to see you today. We're so glad you're here. Can we get you anything? I had to remind myself what I was doing. I'm like, this is not like any other place I've ever been in my life. I would tell my friends about it. I sent 20 referrals to them in the first year, by the way. 20, just me. I would talk about it in my talks. People say, man, where are you going? How do I get the energy you got? I've lost my mojo. What can I do? Everybody see that? They're looking for it, man. Environment is an activator of prey drive. Number four, exposure. Exposure is you see something with the eyes and it expands your mind. This is why I want my kid to see Taylor Swift. I wanted her to see that with her eyes because I grew up in a small town. I was raised by a single mom. We never really had any money. My mom worked 2 and 3 jobs to make sure we had everything. My dad never came to a baseball game. He never told me he loved me. He never came to anything I ever did as a kid. It was just me and this tough single mom, and she instilled in me a prey drive. We dress up, we show up, we grow up, and we deliver. We don't whine, we don't complain, we don't make excuses. Like, she instilled that in me very early in life. Even to this day, if I don't call my mom 3 or 4 days, I'll call her and I'll say, hey, mom, how you doing? You know what my mom says? Who is this? I'll say, what do you mean? Who is this? It's your firstborn child, Mike. Oh, really? Yeah, you're out there being too busy being fabulous? Helping people around the world? You can't even call your own mama that brought you into the world? She's like, I read your book, Million Dollar Follow-Up. It says you're supposed to follow up 7 to 15 times. You can't call me? You know what she says to me? That's an excuse. And you know what? She's 100% right. Yes or no? Environment is an activator of prey drive. And number five, embarrassment is an activator of prey drive. What if I told you I hated losing more than I love winning? It's embarrassing to lose. I hated losing. I hate losing. I don't embarrass people when I coach them, but I will ask them this question. You told me you wanted to do this and you're doing this. Help me to understand why a person as talented as you is playing at the level you're playing at. Help me to understand why you told me you had dreams and hopes and goals, but I see you coming every day like this. Help me to understand where your enthusiasm is. Help me to understand what's going on with you. Did you hire me to tell you you're okay, or did you hire me to help you go to another frequency? Because if you want to go to another frequency, you can't do it at the pace you're doing it at. See how a coach has these honest feedback with people? Do you not think that's what I'd want from my provider if I came to you? See, I'm coming to you because I don't know what to do. I need you to tell me what to do. Yes or no? I don't need you to leave it up to me. That'd be like you coming to me saying, I want to go to another level. Now, what should I do? And me going, you know, I don't know. What do you think you should do? I'd be like, no, thank you for coming here because I know exactly what I've been doing. I know exactly how I can help you. This is the exact recommended plan for you. But here's the deal. It cannot help you if you don't commit to it.